Hello, I'm Professor Wool. Today we'll be discussing how to aggregate network flows into application flows. So if you remember from previous lessons, we talked about learning or discovering application flows from network traffic, either by deploying a sniffer and capturing full PCAP files, or by using a NetFlow source and processing that. Today I want to look a little deeper into this processing part to see what sort of considerations go into doing that well. So our starting point is, let's say, a NetFlow capture. So a list of records, source, destination, and service, which we want to represent as flows supporting some application. If we look at this, an easy observation to make is that you can see a lot of repetition in the service. And also here in this example, all the destinations are the same. It's the one IP address of all these destinations, and there are multiple sources. So the easiest thing to do is to take this representation and convert it to something that looks like what we have here in option number one at the top, where the service is listed once and the destination is listed once, just the IP address. And in the source, we see the list of all the IP addresses that were discovered in the NetFlow, sorted by IP address. This can be done quite easily. However, I argue that this is not very satisfactory for a few reasons. First of all, it's too detailed. There could be, here we have only six, but it could be hundreds or thousands of separate IP addresses appear in the source, and this is too long and too detailed for a person to look at and understand. It's also very accurate. It's too accurate. It records exactly the IP addresses that were seen in the network capture, but it's not future-proof. I mean, if you look at this list, and you can see that IP address .7 and .8 and .13 connected to this destination, it's quite plausible that IP addresses .9, .10, .11, and .12 would also connect to the same web server at some point in the future. They just didn't do so while we were capturing the traffic. And if we restrict ourselves to only the IP addresses that we observed, we get something that is very accurate but not future-proof. So this might not be the best way to represent the flows that we observe. An alternative is what we have here in number two. Instead of having the individual IP addresses listed in the source, we just have the source of any. And then the destination would be that web server and the service is HTTP. So in terms of usability, this is great. This is very compact, just a single record showing what might happen, capturing or describing all the flows that were actually observed, and is completely future-proof. Every possible IP address could appear in the source, and the flow still describes it. So this is good. The downside is, of course, that it is too broad. This is very, very inaccurate. It's not that we saw every single IP address in the internet, and the IP addresses we did see are not uniformly distributed. They are quite focused. There are, you can see that the 10.2 subnet is quite visible, and then we have this outlier in the 3.7 IP address, but it's still pretty focused. So we could do better than this as well. And trying to strike the balance is what I have here in option number three, where you can see that well, the destination and service are as before, but in terms of the source, we have the 3.7.1.7 IP address appears separately as a /32 CIDR block, and the five other IP addresses appear as 10.2.1.0/24, which is wider than what was strictly observed. This allows or describes 256 possible IP addresses, but they're all grouped together in one subnet, so it is future-proof up to a point. So all the IP addresses in the 10.2 subnet are described by this flow, but it's not too accurate, and it's not as detailed as we had up here, and it's reasonably accurate, and it's quite usable because it's still very compact. So it is possible to find this middle ground algorithmically, trying to balance the accuracy against the usability and to produce a compact representation that's still reasonable and usable. Thank you for your attention.